And you made the light from your holy light. And you taught the names and said, Adam, recite. And said, Adam, recite.
Prophet would say to Abu Talib, Rabbaytani sagira wa kaffaltani kabira wa antani yafi'an fajazakallahu anni kull khayr. Rasulullah will say to Abu
Talib, our Lord swore bitter.
Again, if you come to the life of Hazrat Abu Talib alayhi salam, great personality, although history has done injustice to him, Prophet would say to Abu Talib, رَبَّيْتَنِي صَغِيرًا وَكَفَّلْتَنِي كَبِيرًا وَعَنْتَنِي يَافِعًا فَجَزَاكَ اللَّهُ عَنِّي كُلَّ خَيْرٍ. Rasulullah will say to Abu Talib, he said, you brought me up, you trained me while I was young, وَكَفَّلْتَنِي كَبِيرًا, and you took care of me when I was grown up, وَعَنْتَنِي يَافِعًا, and you supported me in each and every situation. Fajazakallahu anni kulla khayr. May Allah reward you on my behalf with every khayr. Rasulullah said to Abu Talib, every khayr. Now somebody will say Abu Talib died as a kafir. Catastrophe. Wallahi al-azim. Amir al-mu'minin would say, sadan nasa wa huwa faqir. Wa ma sadan nasa wa Quraysh faqirun ghayruhu min qabl. Subhanallah. Imam Ali said, Abu Talib, my father, led people in Quraysh when he was poor. And it has never happened in the history of Quraysh, a poor person leading them. He was the Sheikh of Quraysh. This great personality, Abu Talib, teaches us a lesson during hardship, isn't it? Wallahi. There is a lesson. I don't know if Mu'mineen have identified this lesson. And it goes hand in hand with what we are in today. And before I share this lesson with you, there is no Mu'min like Abu Talib. Wallahi al-Azim. Where is Islam without Abu Talib, Habibi? You celebrate Imam Ali, or some call him Sayyidina Ali. To celebrate Imam Ali, to celebrate Abu Talib, who brought up Imam Ali and brought up our own beloved Prophet. Who got married to Fatima bint Asad. If Abu Talib was kafir, there was no way his wife would go to Kaaba and give birth to Ali. It's injustice. Why this injustice? Just to bring Imam Ali down and nothing else. Just to bring Imam Ali down. Because there has never been a warrior, in a true sense of being a warrior, like Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Abu Talib sacrificed not only what he had, his life, for Islam and Rasulullah. He unconditionally supported Rasulullah. Somebody tell me he's kafir. I say, hey, Abu Talib would call Ja'far, his son, and his wife, come and pray behind Rasulullah. Why would Prophet name the year he died as Aam al-Huzn? Why would Prophet equate Abu Talib with Khadija alayhi salam? Why? Kafir? And Prophet Aam al-Khuzr, Khadija and Abu Talib are gone. Now it's finished. Everything is done. Kusha. This was a great personality, Abu Talib alayhi salam. And suffice to say, when he left this world, Imam Ali rushed to inform prophets. Prophet looked at Imam Ali. He said, go and give your father ghusl. Allahu Akbar. You believe in Ali ibn Abi Talib? Said, na Ali. He gave ghusl to Abu Talib. Abu Talib kafir? Hasha lillahi wa kalmi. Allah forbid. Na'udhu billah. Rasulullah said to Imam Ali once evening, when you are lifting his head, call me. He called Rasulullah. Prophet came. You know what he said? Allahu Akbar. He said, Rabbaytani wa kaffaltani kabira wa nasarta wa azart. Allahu Akbar. He said, oh Abu Talib, you brought me up and it took care of me. You supported me and you endured every hardship in doing so. فَأَسْتَغْفِرَنَّ اللَّهُ لَكَ. I indeed ask Allah's forgiveness on your behalf. وَلَا أَشْفَعَنَّ فِيكَ شَفَاعَةً يَعْجِبُ الثَّقْلَيْنِ. He said, I will seek intervention on your behalf with such an intervention that the ins and jinn will be shocked about it.
But what did Zainab Zai see, looking at Ali Yasin?